Hi, welcome to the first episode of Book versus Movie. I'm Logan Devereaux, and let's talk about I Kill Giants. Roll that intro. I Kill Giants is a coming-of-age graphic novel written by Joe Kelly and illustrated by Ken Nimura. It is a coming-of-age story about a 13-year-old girl named Barbara Thornton who is trying to escape the reality of her mother dying of a terminal illness, and she's created a fictional world where she is the hero and she kills giants. She brings along her best friend Sophia to help her fight giants or monsters both in reality and also in her fantasy world. I really, really, really enjoyed this graphic novel. It was really beautifully illustrated and it told a really powerful story. I highly recommend it. Just for the artwork alone, it was absolutely phenomenal. The movie, it was directed by Anders Walter, and it stars Madison Wolf as Barbara Thornton, Imogene Poots as Karen, and Zoe Saldana as Miss Millay. So, let's get into the movie part of I Kill Giants. So, I Kill Giants, like I said, it's directed by Anders Walter, and is his first feature film. And it's pretty good. It's good, but at the same time, this is one of those cases where the trailer and the movie poster are incredibly misleading. You think that you're gonna get like this big epic like fantasy film, when in actuality you get a more emotional drama with little bits of fantasy elements kind of thrown in here and there. Like in the book, our main character Barbara and she's the giant killer. And you kind of go throughout this movie not really knowing if Barbara is right, if there actually is giants out there, or if she's just crazy, or if it's both. And it's pretty good, I'm not gonna lie. I have been seeing it advertised on Hulu for like the past like couple months, and the movie poster just instantly turned me away from it. I have to say, this is probably like one of the most ugliest movie posters I have ever seen in my whole life. It doesn't look good. It does not reflect what happens in the movie whatsoever. This movie actually reminds me a lot of the movie When a Monster Calls, which is pretty good. I like that movie. Another kind of like emotional drama with fantasy elements in here. The difference between the book and the movie is definitely that first like 20 minutes. It's almost similar, but not quite. They changed a few things around, like the characters of Sophia and Taylor. They are completely different from their book counterparts. Barbara pretty much is the same. They also got rid of the fairies that was in the book as well, which I'm not too mad about. I wasn't that big of a fan of the fairies, to be honest with you. I had no idea why they were there. The giants in this, the CGI is not the best, but it's not as bad as it could be, I guess you could say. I wish they would have focused a little bit more on the fantasy aspect of it, because you're going into this expecting it to be a fantasy movie, where in reality you only get about like 10-15 minutes of fantasy in this, and then the rest is you questioning, is Barbara crazy or not? I think you definitely do feel some level of sympathy for Barbara, but not as much as you could. I'm gonna get into spoilers right here, so if you haven't read the book or seen the movie, pause this video, go watch the movie or go read the book. You good? You back? You watched it? All right, let's discuss it. So, it turns out the giants actually are all a metaphor for Barbara's mother's cancer. Her mother has terminal cancer. It's not looking too well. And in fact, she's upstairs in a hospital bed hooked up to a bunch of tubes and IVs and everything. And it's just not looking good for her. So that's why you see Barbara not really wanting to go upstairs onto the other level of their house. And also why Sophia was freaking out. There's a scene where Sophia is giving Barbara a glass of water after she got beaten up by Taylor, and you see Sophia and she's just paralyzed in fear, and you don't know if it's a giant or if Barbara, you know, this whole time she was right, or if there's something else. And for that brief moment, you genuinely do think Barbara's right. There are giants that are gonna come and kill this whole town. I think that was a good scene. I really do think that was a good scene. And it turns out it was just Sophia in shock because she had no idea that Barbara's mom was so sick. At the end of the movie, we know Barbara comes to grips with, you know, her mom is going to die, and she's learned to accept it because during her battle with the giant, the Titan, he said that, you know, in order to, you know, enjoy life, you need to also accept death. And I think that's a really strong and powerful message. So what in all did I think of this movie? I think this movie was, it's pretty good. It's definitely like right up my alley. I was one of those kids that grew up with, The Last Mimsy. Does anybody else remember that? Should I do a review on that sometime? Let me know. Yeah, that movie was insane. It was crazy. It definitely gave me Last Mimsy vibes. But all in all, I think that the movie was very enjoyable to watch. I think it's a very good adaptation of the book, and I highly recommend it. So I'm gonna give this movie a 7.5 out of 10, mainly because the pacing of the movie was way too slow for me, and the CGI was not the best, but I think it is a very good movie. So I Kill Giants, highly recommend it. It's out on Hulu, go check it out. And with that, that concludes the first episode of Book Versus Movie. Thank you so, so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video. All right, bye. Once I was with you, no money, no issue. We laughed even when we were down. I made my mistakes that I paid for in heartache. Now I don't know what to do, 'cause all I think about is you.